I mean, I gave them like 17 years of my life. 17 years. You know, so.
And that's a long time. I mean, a year is a long time.
Man, I gave you 17 years. Is too much.
That is like a lifetime, you know.
Oh, my name is C Money, and this is Chirac, 52.
Laramie and Ferdinand, 5200.
My favorite part about it is just me seeing my homies every day I wake up in the morning.
As far as it being a war on drugs on this block, I don't know. I see the police, but I see police everywhere.
I know they're out here committing crimes all day.
What kind of crimes?
And they sell drugs off the street and stuff like that. Okay. You know, it's just a matter of catching them.
That's a stress for a parent. No parent wants to see their child go to jail, no matter what they've done or how, you know, bad they are. This, you still gonna think about that child as the one you held in your arms.
When police go at me, they gonna search my ass, my boxes, my shoes, everywhere. All that shit. White man, they grab and ask questions.
I think the racial dynamic and landscape needs to be talked about openly.
When they jump out on me, they jumping out like this. When I got the hood on lock, prison bars, looking up at the ground, walking on the damn stars.
Our brothers and sisters, who happen to be people of color, are experiencing levels of injustice and oppression.
I do drugs because if I didn't do drugs, I can't deal with reality.
We all have family members who's on drugs and trying to get off drugs, and it's been very hard for them, especially when it's planted in our neighborhood.
I think the war on drugs is a war on black folk.
I ain't do it for trying to be a thug. I did it to try to survive. So if a job can make me survive, I'm gonna survive.
When I take a look at government, how are they really addressing the issue? And I think one way is not to just look at how do we lessen crime in the community, but how do we first stop the infiltration of guns and drugs within the community?